table 4-7, the tarsal bones, metatarsal bones, and phalanges.
So the foot, our tarsal bones are all in the back portion here. Our first tarsal bone is the calcaneus, which is the biggest one, and it makes up our heel. So it sits like this. So here we have that calcaneus. This is what it kind of looks like. You have this kind of smooth part, and then this part that kind of sticks out over the edge here, which you can kind of see comes under that, and that supports our next bone, which is the talus. The talus bone is very obvious with its very dome-shaped top, and that's for our tibia to articulate right over, and this is what allows us to dorsiflex and plantar flex our foot, is that dome shape that gives us that curve there. So you can see that right here, that very dome-shaped talus. Then we have the navicular bone. The navicular is just anterior to the talus right here. It's kind of long. And then it supports our three cuneiforms. And the cuneiforms can be called any of the following. So we have either first, second, and third cuneiform, which match up with the metatarsals they go with. Or you can call it the medial cuneiform, intermediate cuneiform, and lateral cuneiform. Either are totally acceptable. And last but easiest is this very cube-shaped bone, gets the name cuboid. So he's a nice one for you. Then after that, we have the metatarsal bones, which just like the metacarpals match up with their numbering. So we have metatarsal 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. One being the hallux and the rest just being the digits. Then just like the hand, we have the phalanges as plural or phalanx as one. So our big toe or our hallux is just gonna have a proximal phalanx and a distal phalanx. And then the rest of them will have proximal, middle, and distal phalanx. So again, as Suzette mentioned, you're going to attribute, you would have a proximal phalanx of the second metatarsal, or you could say of the second digit. Either of those would be acceptable.